Welcome, this is How to HubSpot. I'm Thomas. In this video, we're gonna sort through bounces, unsubscribes, and cold prospects with HubSpot marketing contacts, so you can boost your budget efficiency by targeting the leads that truly count. To follow along in this video, click on the link below to get HubSpot's free contact management software. Let's go. Before we dive into the feature, we need to check if you have access to marketing contacts. All new Marketing Hub accounts include marketing contacts. If you purchase your Marketing Hub subscription prior to the introduction of marketing contacts, which was October 2020, you may not currently have access. Here's how to check whether your Marketing Hub subscription includes marketing contacts. What you'll do is you go to the top right where your account name is, go to Account and Billing. Under Products and Add-ons, check whether Marketing Hub subscription shows marketing contacts. If you'd like to gain access, please reach out to HubSpot support. I dropped the link in the description down below. With marketing contacts, you only pay for the contacts you're actively engaging with. You get free storage for all the other contacts in HubSpot Smart CRM. Let's get into it. First, you'll want to label your contact as either a marketing contact or a non-marketing contact. The big difference here is that only marketing contacts can be synced into ad networks from HubSpot, receive marketing emails, SMS, or WhatsApp. Important side note though, you can turn any contact to a marketing contact or non-marketing contact. However, non-marketing contacts are only applied once a month on your next update date. It's also important to determine what a qualified marketing contact looks like for you. You should set up a marketing contact qualification strategy, just like you'd set up a strategy to determine which contacts become a marketing qualified lead. It may not be a lead status property you're working with, therefore I encourage using lists. Lists are the best way to sort through bounces and unsubscribes and making those cold contacts become non-marketing contacts. Just to reiterate, our goal here is to locate our cold leads, make sure that they are switched from marketing to non-marketing contacts. In a list, let's hop right into the CRM. All right, so let's navigate over to the CRM on the left, click on lists. Here on the upper right corner, we're gonna create a list. Because this is contact-based, we're gonna name this email bounces and unsubscribes. That looks great. And then make sure to always keep your list active. Next. All right, the first thing we'll do is add a filter. We're gonna go over to contact properties. We're gonna select email hard bounce. And then click on the list, change is known. Then we wanna add another filter under or. Here we're gonna go to contact properties and we're going to select unsubscribe from all mail. And you're gonna select true. And we are going to save the list. Now we know which contacts have bounced and unsubscribed, making them cold and should be set to non-marketing. So now we need to make sure our future contacts are switched from marketing to non-marketing automatically. Let's do this by creating another workflow. And we're gonna name this workflow Automating Non-Marketing Future Contacts and hit save. So now we'll set up our triggers. Go down to when filter criteria is met, select list membership and choose email bounces and unsubscribes. Then from this, we'll choose is a member of list, apply a filter, save. Next, we'll add a new action, and then we'll go down to marketing and set marketing contact status, choose a value, and this is going to be set as non-marketing contact. Hit save, and just make sure before we turn this workflow on, we select yes, enroll existing contacts, and we are all set. A bonus way to make sure your cold leads aren't taking up marketing contact space is by using custom CRM views. So to create a custom view, go to your contacts page, and at the top right, it says add view. Here, you're gonna create a new view on the bottom left. We're gonna name this view leads. Then we're gonna click on advanced filters and add a filter called lead status. The drop-down menu below that, we're gonna check all the values. And as you can see, the contact list on the left is updating in real time. Now we wanna go to and add a filter, call this marketing contact status. Is any of, and then select marketing contact and your contact list will reflect all the advanced filters you've just applied. In your leads view, we found all the unqualified leads labeled a marketing contact that should now be switched to a non-marketing contact, so it doesn't take up space in your contact tier. And just like that, we have sorted out all your cold leads so you can make sure that your budget is focused on only the high quality leads you care about. Now, if you haven't already, to make the most out of these tips, don't forget to check out our free contact management software in the link below. Well, that's it for me. I'm Thomas. I hope this was helpful, and we'll catch you in the next one.